Hey guys, welcome to M&MM Plants and Pets. If you have seen my Peace Lily video, the care tips of Peace Lily video, in that video I mentioned that I will be propagating one of the part of that plant and I'll be putting it in water and share with all of you how to take care of Peace Lily in water. Right now I already have done one of them, but I want to show all of you how to do it, and then I'll just share a few care tips so that you can have lovely blooms and lovely Peace Lily plants in your water. Let's get started. Alright, so this is the mother plant of mine, the Peace Lily plant, which I'll be using, and I'll just take out the soil. What I will do is I'll just take one of the stems out from the main plant and I will just pot it inside the glass container. Now, because I am taking out the soil and I am, you know, kind of repotting, I would say. So I decided to give it a little bit of fresh, organic compost and cow manure, because if I'm taking out the soil, then I was like, why not give it a little bit of fresh fertilizer so that I do not have to do this again after a few days. When you're doing this process of, shedding the soil away from the roots, don't panic or stress, because even if you break a little bit of roots in the Spathiphyllum or Peace Lily plant, this plant is a very forgiving nature plant. It won't mind a lot, so there is no need to stress a lot even if you break it a little bit. That's the first one, and I'll take one more. So I'll just go with these two, and the remaining I'll just put it back into the soil. So this is my fresh compost and manure that I have, which I will be adding. Right, so my plant is back in his original house. Now, because I've kind of, repotted and given it a fresh fertilizer, I would definitely water it. My plant is happy now with the water. This is a very important process because I'll be putting these stones and pebbles, so I need to wash and clean them very properly. The roots of these Peace Lily plants need to be cleaned properly, because if there is soil and I keep them inside the water, this soil can be the reason that the plant might start rotting up. So I will clean it as much as I can. Once I get it at a level with which I'm satisfied, I think it will be ready for me to put it in the soil. See, as you can see, I've cleaned it. This should be good enough. Now, this is a fresh washed glass container that I have, and the washed and dried pebbles that I'm putting in the base of the glass container so that the roots of Spathiphyllum will get support to grow. In goes the plant. Now, the reason I've selected glass is because I can see the growth of the roots, and honestly, if the container is dark, the roots will love it, because the roots of the plant, they don't need light. Their structure is such that they can grow in a dark place, but because we can put it in a glass container and see the roots growing up healthy, I would recommend you to have glass containers if you want to have water plants. So I'll put these pebbles for the support of the plant, and once that's done, I'll just add a few colorful rocks and pebbles to just give it a little bit of attractive look. There is no need to add any fertilizer. There are few hydroponics hydro fertilizers available. People do add hydrogen peroxide. If you have hydrogen peroxide, you can add one spoon of hydrogen peroxide, or liquid fertilizers like Cecil, I would say. But I have had success in water plants without any fertilizer, so I will not use any fertilizer at this stage. And if I feel there is any need in the future, I might use some. But without fertilizer, it's good, and very less chances of fungal attacks. Now, also what people do is they add fertilizers like NPK with some proportion, and also people add organic fertilizers. Definitely I would not recommend organic fertilizers in water plants, because if you are keeping them inside your house, you might have a foul smell. So please avoid organic fertilizers, I would say. According to me, the best is hydrogen peroxide. Now, the main important thing that I want to share here is that whatever I'm adding inside the glass container has to be clean, so that in few days I do not need to change the water, because there is no need to change the water every now and then, especially if the plant is inside the house. I will change the water after 15-20 days or maybe even after a month, because there is not much dust or pollution inside the house. This is filtered water that is good to drink, so I will use filtered water and not normal tap water. And this will go inside my room where it is in a well-lit position. And I'm not going to keep it outside in the sun or somewhere. Now, peace lilies are sporadic bloomers, I would say. So do not get, sad sometimes when they don't bloom. Just give them a little bit of warm temperature and, humid atmosphere, well-lit position, and that should be enough. Now, whenever people think that, we need a lot of water plants because we love it, there is one of the reasons that people, stop themselves from having a lot of water plants, and that is, what if I have a lot of algae growth and bacterial growth inside the water of my water plants? Now, I just want to share over here that algae growth or any sort of bacterial growth in the water will only be there if the water or the plant, water plant, is exposed in full sun or sometimes even partial sun. If your plant is inside the house where it is not getting the sunlight and it is only getting, it is only in a well-lit position, in a well-lit room, then please don't worry about the algae growth or the bacterial growth, because it won't happen. Even the algae and bacteria, they need full sun to grow. Hence, in order to avoid any sort of algae growth, I would highly recommend all of you to have all your water plants inside the house where it is not getting sun. Now, whenever you are adding water inside your water plant container, you have to make sure that the water level has gone down and the water is drying up before you add fresh water to it. As you can see over here, if you closely have a look, the crown of the plant, from where the top position starts as stem and the bottom as roots, that crown is not inside the water. This is the most important part. If you can have a closer look here as well, I have allowed the crown to stay outside the water. This is the main thing. Hence, rotting of plant will not happen. So hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, then if you're new to this channel, do hit the subscribe button and like the video. And if there is anything you would like to share regarding Spathiphyllums or Peace Lily, please feel free to share your views and opinions in the comment section below. See you next time. Bye bye.